My name is Di Hamill, and I'm from Wild Harvest School of Self-Reliance, and we're at the East Cottingwith Canal. Today we're going to look at some of the wild plants here. Plants that you might find along here, we've got meadow sweet, we've found shepherd's purse, water mint, daisy, dandelion, nettle, dock, rosebay, willow herb, plantain. There's so much. This is meadow sweet. Its name comes from the term sweet and the mead. It likes to grow in the kind of wet areas, damp ditches, and it's actually nature's aspirin. It contains salicylic acid. You can use it to kind of sweeten and cut through tart preserves, like if you were making a rhubarb jam. But I just like to make a tea with it at home, and also infuse it in oil to make pain relief balms. This is the dog rose, and you can use the petals for making the fairy's favourite food, rose petal jam, or also rose petal cordial. I do recommend, if you are doing anything with rose petals, that you cut the heel out, which is the little bit where it attaches to the middle, because that can be quite bitter and overpower all of the taste. You can also dry them out and make floral tea with it. I tend to infuse things in oil and make beauty products. My favourite part of this is leaving them on the tree. Then the following year, when they've been on the tree for kind of 8 months and they're crispy and brown, if you just peel them out and taste them, then they taste a little bit like cardamom. Because what people don't realise is we've got our own native spices here, and ash key seeds are one of our native spices. I've got some hogweed seeds. They taste like a mixture of washing up liquid and orange peel, which doesn't sound very nice as it is, but when these dry at the back end of the season, you can grind them up and use them as another kind of spice. So it goes really nice with like a dark chocolate mousse sprinkled on the top, or any kind of milky puddings, and equally savoury dishes.